each other.
The head of the occupation? In love with a Bajoran?
Ironic, isn't it?
Did your wife know?
No. And she's never going to find out. Now, if you don't mind, Major, I'd rather not talk about this right now. Here are the earrings you wanted.
If Lord's dead, he's not buried here. According to the ship's computers, the Ravenok was attacked by two unidentified warships. The attackers chased the Ravenok here and must have forced her to crash land.
Then the survivors could have been captured and taken away.
Or they could still be here somewhere on this planet.
Maybe we should go up in the runabout and scan for them from orbit.
Too much ionic interference. The sensors would never be able to pick up their life signs. Maybe another way. In these conditions, tricorder readings will only be about 12 meters, but that should be enough.
Enough for what?
During the occupation, Bajoran resistance fighters carried subdermal implants of tritonium isotopes. The idea was that if they were captured, they could activate the implant, which would leave a trail of isotopes so they could be tracked and rescued. I think I have something. That way.
Let's go. I don't know why we have to stop.
For one thing, I can't see 2 meters in front of us. And anyway, we could both use a rest. So stop pacing and sit down. What is it?
Oh, I don't know. I sat on something. Oh.
Let me see.
Oh, get it out.
Well, keep still and let me see what I can do.
Get it out!
Oh, this is gonna hurt.
It already hurts. Just take it out.
If you say so.
No!
Oh. Ouch. Run this dermal regenerator over the wound.
This isn't funny.
It is from this angle.
You know what's even funnier? This doesn't work. Oh, yes. Oh, much better.
You probably should eat one of these.
I haven't had field rations in a very long time. I'm sure they haven't improved a bit.
Actually, it got a little worse. Tell me something.
What?
Who's Torah's Yell? When I reactivated the Ravenok's computer, I downloaded the manifest. There were 2 civilians on board, in addition to the prisoners and crew. One was your friend, Torna Prem. And the other was Torah's Yell, 13-year-old girl.
I suppose you wouldn't believe me if I told you she was Neprem's sister.
Mm-mm. Jiel's a Cardassian name. The way I see it, there's only one explanation. Jiel was Neprem's daughter, and you...
I was her father.